All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Dr. Mark Dybul. He is the CEO of Renovaro Biosciences. And Dr. Dybul, great to see you. How are you?
Great. How are you? Nice to be with you, Steve. Thanks for inviting me.
Good to have you along. Really excited about some recent news you had out. We'll talk about it in just a second, but maybe just give me a bit of an overview of the company itself.
Yeah, so Renovaro, it means to renew, is focused on platform approaches to strengthen our own immune system, to renew the immune system, to retrain it so that it can control diseases on its own. For example, our vision is to eliminate toxic chemotherapy within our lifetime by renewing the immune system to see cancer, chronic infectious diseases in a new way and control it without therapy. We're fairly advanced now. We're moving on the oncology platform in particular towards clinical trials and towards the end of this coming year. And then because of the way we've approached it, we think we could actually be commercial within a year of that or not that long after. And the reason for that is our approach takes a platform approach and an off-the-shelf approach of cells from another person that we take that orchestrate the whole immune system called a dendritic cell. And genetically modify it, put a little bit of the tumor on so that it shows the tumor in a completely new way to the immune system and the immune system can respond. And the data are really powerful. The person who's doing our studies from UCLA, Dr. Anna Jewett, who is one of a leader in immunotherapy for cancers, calls it the holy grail of cancer research because we see the same thing consistently study after study in different models, 80 to 90% reduction in the tumor itself, which in and of itself is impressive. After one round of therapy, we'll probably do 5 to 10 in humans. Secondly, what's left in the tumor is mostly effector immune cells. So it's continuing to kill the cancer. If what was left was a lot of cancer cells, we'd be worried. The third thing is in the blood, in the periphery, we see correlates of the immune system that would allow cancer to be controlled. Important things like gamma interferon, other things we don't need to get into. And that's probably why we also see no metastases. So if you combine reduction in tumor size, dramatic reduction in tumor size, what's left immune cells, what in the periphery immune response and no metastases, that's what she calls the holy grail of cancer research. So now what we're working on is just doing because it's cell therapy, gene therapy, there's a lot that needs to be done for safety for the Food and Drug Administration. But again, we're looking forward to cancer trials. We focus on tumors that are difficult to treat, starting with pancreatic cancer. Dr. Jewett actually designed the animal study for pancreatic cancer. And we do that for two reasons. One is human need. 60,000 people in the US alone, hundreds of thousands in the world are diagnosed with pancreatic cancer every year. No good therapy, 5 to 10% survival rate after 5 years. And if you're not diagnosed early, that's basically 2 to 3%. But also potentially head and neck cancers, triple negative breast cancers, difficult to treat. So we want to give that human opportunity to people to live longer. But importantly, you get through the regulatory system pretty quickly because there's no good therapy. And that's why we think by the end of 2025, early 26, if the results in humans look anything like mice, we'll actually be out in commercial for wide access for a large population. But because the approach we are taking should apply to any solid tumor. If you can treat difficult to treat tumors, you can probably treat easier to treat tumors that we could reach 80% of all cancer patients, because that's where solid tumors are over time. So it's a very strategic approach for human need, but also for a commercial need, which is, you know, to have be a company.
Okay. Just a question on that. So when you're talking about the cells, are you talking about taking healthy cells from other people and using them within someone, or are you talking about healthy cells from someone and then bringing them back into their body?
The first, and that's important because there are others using the cells from the person. That can take longer, especially if you don't use stem cells, or if you use stem cells, which we're doing. And you make dendritic cells out of them. And dendritic cells orchestrate the whole immune system. We tend to think we're smarter than the immune system in nature. We're not. There's a lot we don't know. And so why not use the cell type that the nature has evolved to orchestrate the whole immune system and then upregulate through gene therapy key markers on the that tell the whole immune system how to work? And that's why the genetic modification with that otherness, that allogenicity, is so important. It also allows you to be off the shelf. And that's because the immune system will respond in a much more dramatic way if you have cells from another person and they're genetically modified to orchestrate that broader immune system. But it also allows it to be very off the shelf because you can store those. If you have to get them from the person, you have to get them, modify them, change them, then give them back later. We can actually take them off the shelf as soon as we have a piece of tumor and know what the otherness definition is genetically for the person.
Got it. Okay, good. You signed a definitive deal recently with the company, a very significant one. And I read in the news release that basically it can take the company in a direction much faster and much quicker. So tell me about this definitive deal you signed.
Yes, yeah, so the definitive deal was is with an AI company called GEDiCube. It's a fantastic company that has had in development their AI. And a friend of mine said, we have to take the BS out of AI. Everyone's saying they have AI right now. This is true AI, which is deep learning algorithms trained to identify things that the human mind and regular computing can't do. And they've been developing this for 10 years. It actually started as fintech and then modified to health tech. And they've developed what are called panels, multi-omic panels, meaning not just one type, one thing, but multi approaches, genomics, proteomics, transgenomics, all in the same panel for a single disease. And they have over 3,300 panels, and including 13 cancers that's been validated in humans for the diagnosis of lung cancer. And that has been award-winning. So it's deep learning, deep technology that can identify things that we can't identify through current systems. They're also adding different modes, imagery, through a partnership with NVIDIA. Of course, you know, NVIDIA, Inception program. In fact, the CEO of the company came from NVIDIA. And so by adding that technology, that health tech to biotech, we bring together two extraordinary worlds that on their own can do something. But when you find what I call Ventech, the where the two worlds collide or come together, we can accelerate on multiple fronts. So for example, with blood alone, we believe, and we are working on GEDiCube, is where I have to be clear, we signed the definitive agreement, we're waiting for the proxy. So the board, the shareholders have to vote. But with blood alone, you should, with biomarker panels, be able to identify cancer before you can pick it up by regular methods. So identify early stage cancer or even the likelihood of developing cancer. Then you could predict whether or not someone's going to respond well to therapy. And for example, PD-1 inhibitors, huge in oncology right now, supposed to be $145 billion business. About 60% of people fail PD-1 inhibitors. Wouldn't it be great to know if someone's going to succeed or fail? For two reasons. One, if you know you're going to fail, don't take the therapy because you won't find out for 6 or 12 months. So you've got cancer growing inside of you. And then it's very difficult to respond. But also so that you can pick the right therapy. So diagnose early, predict the right therapy, and then pick up recurrence earlier. And if you can do that, you have a better chance at therapy because the earlier you diagnose or pick up recurrence, the more likely you are to succeed in therapy, particularly if you can predict what is most likely to succeed. But you can then also find potential new targets through the deep learning algorithms for the people who are failing. And so we'll use this on the biotech side in our own clinical trials. We'll be putting our data into their system, which will help in each way. But they'll also be able to help us identify new products, but also get commercial products out that relate to cancer for a vision that we have of a world free from toxic chemotherapy within our lifetime by earlier diagnosis, predicting results, earlier diagnosis of recurrence and immunotherapy that doesn't require toxic chemotherapy, which gets to what I think is going to redefine the future of medicine.
Yeah. Just to wrap up here, give me some thoughts on 2024. You mentioned earlier, it's going to be a very significant year for the company. Just what people should look for next year from you and the team.
Well, we're, as we've said, we believe that we will have our first AI-generated technology in the commercial market. We believe it will be for early diagnosis, could be others in the commercial market in next year, towards the end of next year. Also start our clinical trial on the biotech side, so that will already be bringing clinical patients in. And then by the end of 2025, early 26, potential commercial approval for use of that product in human beings to treat cancers that are difficult to treat, but could treat all solid tumors. So next year, AI products in the commercial market, 2025, early 26, biotechnology, cancer products, immunotherapy that could eliminate the need for toxic chemotherapy and difficult to treat cancers.
Dr. Dybul, thank you so much. Good luck with everything. There's a great need out there, obviously. You mentioned some of those cancers that really have no treatment and sometimes set death sentences on people. So we really appreciate your time and good luck with everything.
Thanks, Steve. Have a great day.
You as well. Dr. Mark Dybul, he is the CEO of Renovaro Biosciences.